Hinduism is the world's oldest religion, stretching back over 4,000 years. Its early roots are obscure, with no one founder or defined starting location. In fact, many Hindus think their faith is as timeless as time itself. Hinduism mandates honesty, abstaining from damaging living creatures, patience, self-restraint, morality, and compassion, among others. Hindu activities include rituals such as devotional recitations and meditation. Its oldest known beginnings are located in the Indus Valley culture, with which it shares similar religious rituals, including ceremonial bathing sacrifices and goddess worship. The Vedic era is so termed for the creation of the four Vedas, regarded everlasting heavenly revelations authored in Sanskrit, the basic language of Hinduism. The Rig Veda is the oldest, biggest, and possibly most important Veda, consists of more than 1,000 lyrical hymns and centered mainly on the pantheon of God. The Veda hypothesized about a linked world with a singular unifying force underlying an otherwise variegated cosmos named Brahman. Although most Hindus believe that Brahman is the ultimate source of everything, it is not worshipped as a god and is not viewed as a single deity. Instead, all male deities are supposed to separately embody the numerous facets of Brahman. Arik Veda was devoted to the creator deity, called Brahma, is regarded to be the genesis of the caste system since it created the four social classes of Hinduism. These four classes were supposed to have emerged from the bodily parts of Brahma: priests from the mouth, nobles from the arms, commoners from the thighs, and slaves from the feet, according to the Vedas, to make existence meaningful. Hindus should pursue four goals simultaneously: generating and distributing wealth, indulging in pleasure, seeking emotional fulfillment, pursuing liberation and release by not being overly attached to anything, and being socially responsible by following a code of ethics and duties, which is the Dharma. Traditionally recognized as the most authoritative book on Hindu law, the Mansamrita elaborates on the Dharma and prescribes them to each of the four varnas or classes, arguing hence the caste system is the foundation of social order. Connected to the Dharma is the core principle of karma, according to which virtuous deeds always obtain good results and vice versa. Reincarnation is key to Hinduism, and karma is thought to operate not only in this lifetime but also across lifetimes, meaning that one's future lives and the caste in which they may be will be conditioned by actions performed during one's present life, which itself has been conditioned by the actions performed in previous lives. Significant literature of Hinduism also include the two extremely large epic poems Ramayana and Mahabharata. They expounded on the deities and ideologies established in the Vedas and were partly based on real events that took place in the ancient Hindu kingdoms. The first formal Hindu temples were established during this Puranic era and were devoted to prominent Hindu deities such as Vishnu, the protector, and Shiva, the destroyer of the cosmos. 5th century India was a period of major religious and philosophical change in reaction to what was viewed as the inadequacy of Hinduism to serve the needs of people. Many schools of thought arose, including Buddhism, headed by Siddhartha Gautama, who was a Hindu prince, although it is frequently referred to as an offshoot of Hinduism. Buddhism opposes the Hindu caste structure and abandons its rituals, priests, and gods, while Gupta kings embraced Hinduism as a uniting religion. The fall of their empire led in the emergence of regional kingdoms devoted to distinct deities, but Hinduism in general remained the most popular since it incorporated all Hindu mythology and theology. After centuries of conquest, Muslims became the main political power in India, but some Islamic kings were indulgent to Hindu rituals. Muslims, particularly after 15 years, forbade the worship of Hindu deities and demolished several holy temples in 1757. The British victories signaled the end of Muslim supremacy. Initially, the British permitted Hindus to practice their faith freely, but soon Western missionaries attempted to convert Hindus to Christianity. This was a moment of internal reform and revolt, with Hindu missionaries rising to free the faith of the so-called Christian superstition. The British Raj also furthered the establishment of the caste system, making it more rigid and incorporating it into the British system of administration. Upper and lower castes were separated. Priests would not take food or drink from the servants, and one could only marry inside their own caste. British colonialism and Christian missionaries surely acted as spurs for expanding Indian nationalism, with Indianness increasingly related to the burgeoning idea of Hinduness. Gandhi himself relied upon established Hindu values, especially non-violence and non-violence, in his march for Indian independence following the end of colonial authority. India was partitioned into sovereign countries with a Hindu majority. India, and the mostly Muslim Pakistan, the independent Indian constitution forbade discrimination based on caste, yet certain societal customs of marrying solely from one's own caste are still occasionally practiced today. The third biggest religion in the world has unquestionably had a major effect upon Western society, from the Beatles' preoccupation with transcendental meditation in the 1960s to modern-day yoga practice.